Okay, we are given a discrete probability distribution. How do we know it's discrete? Discrete countable numbers. One thing you should always check, is this really a true probability distribution? How do you know? All probabilities must be between 0 and 1. And if you sum all probabilities, they should add to 1. So you should always check that first. All right, so let's say that I want to find the mean and the standard deviation. And of course, if you wanted the variance, you just wouldn't square root, right? Remember that? Remember that? All right, so the mean, our expected value, is by taking each x value and multiplying it by its probability and then add all of those up. So I'm going to just set up a spreadsheet where this way, if these numbers change, now I might have more numbers, but I could reuse this. So let's just over here, let's call this my x times p of x. So I know what that column means. So I actually get the same format there. And then from here, I'm going to take each x value times its probability. I can copy that, repeat that formula straight down. And then for the mean, that's that big old E there, just says to sum all of those values. And I get 1.65. Okay, so that's my answer. Now what I want to do is I want to find the standard deviation. And you'll see this written in different forms. I don't know, I kind of like the first form because I'm used to the standard deviation in words, how far away a data value is from the mean. And so that's just, I kind of like this formula better, but you can use either one. So notice what we're going to do. So that's going to be this piece here, which is going to be my x value minus the mean quantity squared times the probability of x. So once again, let's make that party. And so I'm going to do this here where I'm going to take each x value minus the mean. Now, I want to copy this formula straight down because I'm so lazy and I don't want to retype it every time. To do that, you absolute reference this cell. And on the keyboard, if you have a PC, you can just press F4. Or you just type dollar for the column, dollar for the row. So $9, $19. So that's an absolute reference that says absolutely reference that cell when I copy this straight down. So don't move the actual cell. And then squared and then times my probability of X. And I take this and I drag it straight down. So notice if I like double clicked on one of these formulas, I can see the only thing that moved was my X and my P of X. The mean didn't. That's the whole point of absolute referencing. All right, so looking here at the formula, I've done everything inside. I just need to sum it and then take the square root. So I'm going to say square root of the sum of these values, close the sum, close the square root, and I get my answer. And of course, you can change it to however many decimal places as needed. Oops, wrong way. As needed. La, 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 there we go. But now I have something set up where if I'm given another problem and these values change, like 0.25, 0.20, then automatically I can get my answer. So you saw when I was messing around over here that all these values were changing. And that's if you don't get anything out of this course but Excel reusability, so I can use this over and over and over. Now you might have to add rows and manipulate your formula, but you won't have to do a lot of different things. So again, I just added this to my probability tab that I had added last week. And just things that aren't in here, I would like to add so I have it available when I get ready to either do similar problems in homework or quizzes and tests.